You understand what is not digital first. You try to get leads. Digital doesn't work like that. All of you can hear me, right? You understand what is not digital.
So before I start, a little bit of intro will help me, because I was told most people come in conference, they give gyan and they move, right? And people who are in the audience, they have some real pain, real problems. They don't know how to go back and solve it. I just want what type of crowd I'm talking to, I would like to know. And if you have any question, I have a piece of paper, I'll give it to you. You can ask me anything particular related to your business, the problem which you are facing. My job is to solve it. So starts, whoever wants to start, you can tell me what, if you're a participant and you have a question, what type of family business or what type of category of industry you're managing. So I see a diversity. I see one guy is a corporate guy. I see him from Siemens. Rest all of you are from own business, family business. I think that's going to be more relevant. The problem which I want to solve here is that each one, if you have some issue or facing your problem, this topic I picked up is based on the reference I'm going to talk. Why most of the people I see here are all individual, family business. You are trying out new things. You are trying to solve issues, problems. So I must tell you certain myth, bust I will do, so that you understand what is not digital first. Because I see most of you come from a traditional background. You're trying to understand digital, right? So this slide, quickly I'll run. So you can Google me, just now the gentleman did. I am available on 13 social media platforms. Even if you don't search my full name, the first one, Shubha Broto, you don't have to spell the full name also. The moment you reach the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 alphabets, if you do, Google will show you. You must be looking for this Shubha Broto. I stand number one in the Google. You will actually find me if the network is good in 0.45 seconds. Yeah, so most of my, I'll give you my card, my also visiting card doesn't have any information. No email, no phone number, nothing. Because I get found so fast. So I'm going to tell you how you can get found. Okay. By the way, I don't pay a single money to Google. No SEM, zero SEM, and zero, SEO for making Google find me. I do that. How do I do that organically is what I'm going to teach you. I run a consulting firm. I worked for almost 25 years. I think the average age I see here is 25. So I'm almost, before you just took birth, I was started working. So around 26 years actually, I worked for in the corporate life. Last job was CMO. I was working in the Netcore, which is a marketing automation software company. I worked in almost 11 categories. Started with Coca-Cola, and then Reliance, then ICICI Bank. You name it, I've worked most 11 industries. Since only pharma I have not touched. So retail I have touched, bus I have touched, pharma I have touched, jewelry I have touched. 11 category I've been, worked as a brand manager, marketing manager, and so on and so forth. And recently, for the last 2 years, I built my own consulting firm, which is Digital Fellow. I have consulted so far 102 industries, which includes also pharma. So quickly, let's run. This is the first mistake most family-owned marketing people do. They first want to try leads. I think Harsher did the same thing. You try to get leads. Digital doesn't work like that. Imagine why. The moment you have not got anything out of Facebook, because it's like that. If I meet you for the first time, and if I keep on looking at your wallet from the starting of the conversation to the end, will you like it? No. You're doing the same mistake, Harshad. You should not start with lead generation. Lead will come. It's a byproduct. There's a process. Most people do this mistake. Not only small company, large company also. They want lead. It doesn't go. So before even talking to the customer, before even talking to who you are, what you do, you're jumping and saying, can you give me your money? I need to sell it. Doesn't work. First mistake. This is the second mistake people do. So what happened? Google talk about Google ads everywhere. And Facebook talk about Facebook ad. YouTube talk about YouTube. So most people get confused what is digital marketing. They think you should not do Facebook, you should do Google. And Google and Facebook are fighting with each other. So Google will tell you, no, come back to me. You pay me money. You do me SEO, do SEO for me. I'll help you that you will get found. Google AdWords will also not work. There's also a process in the Google AdWords. Google AdWords is paying to Google and making your product found. So there's a process which I'll come and tell you. If you don't follow that process, whatever you're going to spend, nothing will work. So like Harshad, most of you will get a feeling that digital don't work actually. I think we should go back to poster and hoarding and, you know, POP and kiosk, you know, and that's getting costly day by day. This is the third mistake I see everybody. Everybody think posting on social media is digital. You must post something because from X company to Y company to Z company, everybody is posting. Happy New Year, X Jayanti, Independence Day, X Holi. Everybody post. So I should also post irrespective of, I really don't know, since everybody is posting, let me post. I think something will happen. So this is called pray. First you are spraying the money and you are praying that someone will see you and come. It's called spray and pray theory. It doesn't work in digital. Digital is quite complex. Absolutely very, very complex. It's like how you manage an orchestra. It has so many people and so many resources. So many skills are required to run digital. Most people think it's so easy because Facebook says boost. And it says just pay me 1,000 rupees. I'll show this ad to 20,000 people. Oh my God, it's so easy. If I have to take a hoarding or a radio or a TV or a bus stop or whatever, it's going to cost me 1 lakh. And so digital is so cheap. It doesn't work like that. Okay? Product selling is not digital marketing. So many people mistake by thinking if you're doing selling, selling is not marketing. So like Harshad, most of you will end up trying to sell. In a digital platform, you're not supposed to sell. I'll give you an example so that you will understand. So when you have a fleet company, right? So how many sales people you have? How many business development people you have? Most of the people have a sales team. Sales people, right? 10 people based on the size, 15 people, 20 people. If you're all over India, you will have 100 sales people. And these are the people who go and try to go and, you know, get business. I don't have a single salesman. ZDRO, zero. I don't have a salesman. I sit back. By the way, I come in office in shorts. I generally don't wear even a full pant because I don't go out and look for client. Client come to my social media. They first of all find me. They come, they see my content again, again and again. They started feeling this guy is talking and educating. He's not selling. He's not looking at my pocket. He's educating. He's telling me 20 things you should do to do your business better. So let me get in touch. So I get found. So you must be thinking, so how much you've done? Close to a crore in the shorts without going out, no meeting, no pitch, and in visiting card there's no number. And I don't go networking also. So I do everything on social media, on internet. I'm going to teach you everything, all the secrets which I am here. By the way, I'm a first time entrepreneur. My father was a professor. We come from a very humble Hindu family. So none of my family member did ever business. So I'm going to teach you things which made me a few crore, bring these techniques right. This is the biggest problem I see. This is the problem for which millions and lakhs of companies, hundreds of companies are failing on digital. With a traditional mindset, you cannot manage digital. What is a traditional mindset? Mindset is, let's do the cheapest Facebook ad. Why do I have to pay money to get image? Let me copy paste something from the Google free image. Why pay for an image? Okay, so I'll tell you the disasters happen if you do that. So these are mindsets, which means as cheap as possible. It's like you want to go to Mars and you're looking for a Maruti 800 engine. Will it work? It will never take off. So you're looking at a very considerable amount of output, but you're looking at a very small input, very cheap post. So this mindset kills people. With this mindset, you will not be able to go farther. And not only small companies or small SMEs, large companies also do that. You know why? Because the marketing head of that company is a 45-year-old guy, is a head or a CEO, come from a traditional school, come from a traditional mindset. They will see, no, what's the point of building brand? Maal bejo, dhanda chahiye. So same thing happens, it doesn't work. Because of this problem, most campaign, activity, everything fails. And you know what happens, the biggest reason of this, most people try to learn digital through YouTube. They get certifications, small agencies, 10,000, 5,000, 2,000, learn digital in 2 days, right? So I was asking, it's like, you ask someone, so what is your skill? He said, oh, I am a swimmer. Wow. I'm a certified swimmer. Okay, so where did you learn swimming? He said, I've learned swimming on my bed because I got a certification from YouTube. I know all the backstroke, frontstroke. Now you're laughing, exactly what people do. With a half-baked knowledge, with reading 5 blogs, 2 posts, 1 video, they are self-proclaimed digital marketer. If you go to their LinkedIn profile, 90% of profile I see are all fake and very stupid. Everybody try to catch up with the trend. So there's a Bitcoin happening. He will change the profile, Bitcoin enthusiast. What does it mean? I also don't know. Digital happening, they will say digital expert. I go and check the profile. The guy has only worked in a digital small SEO firm for even 3 months. He's saying he's an expert. So everybody expert in the digital world. Life catch you. When a real problem comes, you're not able to solve. Because if you learn swimming on YouTube, watching YouTube video, definitely you will know swimming, but once you're thrown in the pool, you know what happens. Same thing happens. Most of you will half-baked knowledge, half-baked approach. Desktop content is not mobile content. Most people don't understand that. And you know what happens? So they can catch first thing you need is a website. So you will catch the cheapest guy on the neighbor. How much money will it take to make a website? Sir, 15,000. 15,000 is so costly. He's actually having an iPhone Pro with 1.425 lakhs. But I think making a website is 15,000 costly. No. Can I negotiate? Someone will say, no, I will make it in 5,000 rupees. Wow, what a deal. He will actually go and make a shitty website, which a Google crawler will not able to figure out how the website look like on a phone. So when you make a website, you actually make 2 versions. One is a mobile responsive ready, one is a desktop ready. Some content are not available if you are going through a desktop or a mobile, and some content available if you're going through a mobile or a desktop. So your content format change, your design change, your flow change. Generally user experience, a guy who made the architecture of a web from of a website, his salary is at least 2 lakh rupees a month. Imagine a designer charges 2 lakh rupees, a very costly, a high-end profile designer. Do you think a website will cost 10,000 rupees or 20,000 rupees? So, you're buying something look-alike, but it's not. It's like a salt and a sugar, all are white, but both taste different. That's the biggest problem. You know, you can get a free website on Wings.com. Okay? So first, startups or whoever wants to start business, let's not spend money into this. First, buy something which is the cheapest thing. So why don't you went to the cheapest government school in a village? Why you spend money into a good college? You should have chosen your career like that. No? So why your dad has sent you to the good college? Did your dad did a comparison? This college has a 15-acre place. And this college is in village. This is 20,000 times cheaper. So that's not it. Build your life. So website is your life. Website is your heart. Your attitude will kill you. If you're looking at a website, your entire business asset is based on a website. So desktop version first or a mobile ready is a concept not much understood by a guy who is a neighbor who can do your website in 10,000 rupees. He will not know. So before you start, you get killed, okay? Traditional content writing is not equal to digital content writing. I see lots of fake content writers. What happened? Content writing of a normal content writer and a digital content writer is a very different zone. I'll tell you how. You have a general physician and you have a heart surgeon. They're same. Why? The general physician charge you 200 rupees and the heart surgeon or eye surgeon will charge you 2,000 rupees for even talking for 5 minutes. And there are certain doctors who don't even operate and do anything. They advise you, Second time you go and advise and they charge you more. Same thing happens. If you're looking at a content writer who don't know what is, now how will you know? I will tell you all the tricks to catch fake people. Okay? So content writing, normal content writing. So imagine you are thinking that your website and your digital is wow and wonderful. Your daughter, your sister, your mom, everybody becomes a content writer. And you think with that power you will to make business. Oh my God. Before you take off, it will die. So there are techniques. And they are very, very technology driven techniques. By the way, small thing you must tell you. When we write a content, we don't write content for human beings. Cosmopolitan, you have heard the name? Vogue magazine? Anyone have not heard this name? Raise hands. Cosmopolitan and Vogue international magazines? Okay, few. These are basically female, international, one of the best magazines on fashion. So if you, I don't know how many people know this, 30 to 40% of the content of the Cosmopolitan magazine are written by robots who are content experts, not by human beings. So you give them keyword, the robot with the help of AI software will do a research, will create content which are absolutely original with all proper SEO, and you will make that content. And they charge, you can also do that, it charges $35 to $40. You can write content with the help of a robot. And you're reading a content of a robot which you don't know. Think about it. And you think your next door auntie or uncle or daughter's wife or husband's some relative who is just a right is to do little poetry will make your content and that website will go up and Google Spider will recognize it. Dreamland. It's like trying Maruti 800 and trying to go to Mars. So Tesla versus 800. I'm not demeaning the two brands, but one has different place to be in, right? This is something interesting. Most content writer or marketeers don't understand this. I will tell you in a very simple manner. I have not used a single word jargon. I'm trying to make it very simple for you. It's like someone, all of you are veggie or non-veg, because I'm a non-veg, my reference will be little, veg, okay, fine. So, veg, okay. What do you have in dinner? Huh? No, after sunset. Roti sabji. So you get roti. Do you want to have a roti sabji at 4 o'clock in the morning? Maybe no. So example, or you have a dessert. Will you like to have a dessert at early morning at when you get up? No. Probably no. If you are a lover of dessert, you will have. But majority so, your food has certain context based on timing. Content work like that. If you give stupid content randomly, just what I said, spray the content and praying that someone will read it. Spray and pray concept, if you try, nothing will work, no campaign will work, no blog will work, no post will work, nothing will work. Only you will feel, wow, I have done 400 posts. How to understand context? There's a process and the theory of a business funnel, of a consumer journey, how the consumer eats, what he eats, on what platform he eats, what type of content he eats in what platform. If you don't know that, you're just praying that someone will read it. So no content will work for you, nothing will work. These are something not known. So most of the people I see here, you guys are not a true marketeer. You're trying to figure out. So hire some people who understand. Okay, so don't go to a compounder who also wear like a doctor white dress and think that you're getting checked by a doctor. Yeah? So there's a difference between doctor and a compounder. So that's a difference between an expert and an unskilled guy. Oh, this is the favorite thing most people do. Cut, copy, paste. No one is watching, you think, right? Because what will happen, you went to that website guy or a content guy, some auntie or uncle or auntie's daughter, a budding writer, self-proclaimed content expert is copying something from somewhere and giving it to you. And you also don't know what you got. You go, wow, wonderful, beautiful. Oh my God, you have used such nice English. Right? He gives it to you and you put it on your website. The moment you put it on a website, phrase by phrase, word by word, Google's crawler can figure out where that content, from where all it has been got. And what happened? It makes sure your website reputation goes down. So your 20,000 content writer will not work. Just like a Maruti 800 will never take you to the moon. Very simple, right? This is the biggest problem. I want views, I want likes. And people think this is what you should make content. There's nothing to do with likes and views. A great content will always get found. It takes time, it will always get found. Impatient people, so you pick up your dad or your mom's business, you're impatient to get some like. You go to Instagram, you buy some like, and at the night you feel happy, wow, my likes have gone up to 2 million. Your dad asks you, so how much business are you thinking you'll get from this 2 million? He'll say, no, actually nothing. You're all fake followers we bought. Yeah, this is happening. So don't get fascinated by like. It has nothing with your business. Even if you have 50 likes, 100 likes, you can do business. When I started my business 3 years back, so it's not much of like or whatever I got, right? If you Google my name, which I few people who came a little late, for you, my name is Shubham Rondo. I run a digital consulting firm in Bombay. So I work for various large corporations and mid-term companies. I consult World Bank. By the way, for an example, if I give you, World Bank has some 30 parameters to work with World Bank. Since I was new, I didn't have a single parameter to match. Since I never applied, World Bank guys came and said, we want to work with you, we have seen your work. So they wave off all the points and said, Shubham, we want to work with you. And it was Deloitte or Accenture who was supposed to do this job. We got the job. Okay, so you get found. At that point, I didn't have life. I didn't have great numbers to followers. What I had? Amazing content. So what is the power of content? As I speak to the writer in front of you, 120 content get published by 4 o'clock. Every single day. 120. So I never have to pay Google. If you search my name, if you just write Shubham Rondo, even if you do a wrong spelling, Shubham Rondo Chakraborty, in whatever AO, whatever you do, still Google will say, this is a Shubham Rondo. I will come in the first three or first four to show you. I think you're looking for this Shubham Rondo. That's the power of content. So my content is sprinkled in such a manner. How hard you try, Google has no other option but to search me. Try your name first on your Google image. Okay? You will not find your face. Very unlikely out of 100 pictures of Google image, you will find one or two, maybe out of your LinkedIn or Facebook. Okay, if your name is Akshay or whatever, or Rahul or whatever, you will find the Rahul, the hero or some film star named Rahul will come on the first. So there will be at least what, 1 lakh, more than 1.5 lakh Shubham Rondo alive, just to birth or just got dead in the entire planet. Why do I come number one? Just the power of content marketing. That's the power. So the lady in the green, you just try, can you see? Have you gone to Google? You see what I'm saying, you can test. She just tested, right? And I know her, I don't know her. Now try one thing, try your name, just the first name. And I can bet my life, I will leave the podium, you can take the podium. If you get your 5 picture on the Google image on the 500 post, try, you'll not get it. No one will get it. No one. And imagine how many total pictures versus your picture. Total picture, I said. No. Total picture will be 40. The third picture, which is 1, 40 is to 1. So I said 5 is 200 billion. Right? So that's the fact. You checked my website, right? Because of some glitches, it's not open. If you go, I've not spent a single money to go. Okay, so I speak in various forums. Apart from my work, I am a faculty for IIM Indore for the last 4 years. I'm a faculty for IIM Digital Marketing for Kashipur. I am IIT Kharagpur. I'm going coming month. So I get called by different this place. Who called me? I didn't apply. I didn't see your post. One of you sitting here was seeing my post for a long, long time. So that gentleman said, Shubham, I heard something is happening in Pune. Will you be coming? So I got found every single time. One more interesting thing, I'll tell you the power of content marketing. I don't have any CV of my people who work with me. You know why? None of the people have hired. Because I never put up an ad. Because I never put a post. Come, we are hiring. Everyone came and found me. So got discovered. So they said, okay, Shubho, I heard your lecture. I want to work with you. So the way I get business is the same way I get my people. This is the power called inbound marketing, the power of attracting your customer. So I come in shorts. Here I can't, I'm not supposed to. So that's the reason I come in shorts. You can go and check out, right? I hardly go out. I'm always in the office, either I'm traveling or when am I going on a speech. I always get found. That's the power of inbound marketing. Not much people in this country understand inbound marketing. They only understand one thing. Pay some Google, pay some Facebook, get a guy, pay some 15, 20,000, make some shitty thing and try. And if it works, it works. If it doesn't work, digital is not working. It's not good. That's the blame you try to do. Next. So just quickly go article, checklist, white paper. Yeah. Ask any of your blog writer, whoever is writing blog for you. Can you explain me the definition and the grammar of a blog writing? What are the things required to write a blog? What is the difference between blog and content? Okay. Or what is the difference between blog, content and article? Okay, what is the difference between article, blog, content, white paper, research paper? A 5,000 rupees guy or a per word, 1 rupee per word guy will definitely not do. He is a compounder, not a dentist or a doctor. Or not a heart surgeon. So your digital will never work. How hard you try, it will never work. Okay? So these are mistakes. So spray and pray is what I just said. On a content channel, you make, you know what people see here, I see here, you make one poster of Holi or Independence Day and spray it everywhere. You have an offer. Same offer, cut, paste, post, post, post. Cut, paste, post, post, post. You're giving idli in the 4 o'clock, idli in the afternoon, idli in the morning, idli in the evening, idli at 3 o'clock, 6 o'clock. Content doesn't work like that because human beings don't work like that. Human beings don't eat the same content in different format. You need skilled people to make you cook. So these are issues. So these are the reasons digital marketing is not understood, fail all the time. Large companies do this mistake. Because technically always the boss is the idiot, right? Yeah, so that boss creates the problem. The new guy who goes out in conference, they will pay money too so that you should go. You should learn, you know. You should go to conference. See, I paid you 2,000 rupees to this conference. I paid you 5,000 to do a HR training on digital. But no, don't try this. Just do what I'm telling you. Thankfully, all of you are owners. All of you manage your family business. You don't have a load of your boss, your own boss, right? You should not do this mistake, right? Otherwise, digital doesn't work. This is important. What is different with organic food and normal food? You get a lot of food which are, they put a lot of carbohydrate, right? So not unhealthy. Same thing happens in the content marketing. So most people look for paid growth because they're impatient. I want, you know, 1 lakh or 1 million TikTok followers. I want 50,000 Instagram followers. If I don't have followers, I can't, you know, look into the eyes of a competitor because he has more followers. So let's pay money some or the other reason so that at night I can say, wow, I have many. Doesn't matter if it's working or not, at least I have many. You have those kids going out and buying toys. At home they have toys, they don't play it, right? Many Barbie dolls, you hardly play with that doll. You just buy it because you think, you know, you must, because your neighbor kid also have 7 Barbie dolls, so you must have it. The same psychology I see here on content marketing or on video. No one is willing to have time patiently building content. Everybody is too much in hurry. So that is the reason most of the digital business is dead or getting killed very fast. Influencer. This is a new thing. In fact, I'm writing a blog. Fake influencer. I'm going to write this blog. I've already spoken because right now I don't get time to write. So I say all this thing to my writer and she writes and show me. Everybody has become an influencer. Right? Any goddamn people you meet, everybody's influencer. Someone is a food influencer. He just went to five shops, had 5 vada pav or pav bhaji and started writing, I'm a food enthusiast, I'm a food influencer. He will go and she will go and buy Instagram, 20,000 rupees from his dad's money to prove that he's influencer because he will show, see, I have 5 million followers, so please pay me, I'm an influencer. life catches you because there are software. If I run that software, I can tell you, even if you have a Twitter follower, I can tell you which all followers are fake. Now the brands have become smarter. Brands are not fools, because the marketing head will just take your IT handle of your Twitter handle or your Instagram handle, run it, pass through that software, it will tell you 20 or 80% of your followers are fake and bought. So the death of an influencer happened. Influence is nothing wrong, but everybody is trying to, you have, all of us read that book, Pied Piper, everybody is chasing the same rat, it's a rat race. Everybody thinks you can become a Gary Vee, you can become a Kale, you can become anyone else, because you think the easiest way without doing much effort, if you just become somehow of some food or some fashion influencer, you are, life is sorted. Life is difficult because software is killing. Yeah, so YDS said perfect lunch. So your website should have type of food. Your website should have a stale food. Buffet is a stale food, all of you know that, right? You don't get a fresh food. Buffet is yesterday's meal. Something new happens sometimes. So your website should be not bad. Your website should be fresh content. So with what? 10,000 rupees content that you will get a good food, like a chef. No, you'll get buffet. Copy paste from 20 other places. So yeah, one more thing. Content building, people think is a one night shot. Once I'll one blog, 10,000 I will spend, write 15 blogs, and I am sorted. I got follower, I have YouTube, I have bought everything, now I'm sorted. Now you are just guessing and anticipating and guesstimating that one day something will happen. There's nothing is going to happen on any social media, because content making is a lonely effort. Content making is an everyday work. Do you sometime brush and sometime don't brush? Sometime you go to loo and sometime you don't go to loo? Sometime you take bath and sometime you don't take bath? Sometime you eat, some few months you don't eat? No? Content is like that. You do it every single day. Otherwise, why will I make 120 content every single day? I have a pipeline till March. Which means, even if I'm in Pune, my content team is right now publishing. How will you think that what Shubho is saying on the podium is right? You can check back any of my social media. Go to the last content which got posted. You will see within 2-3 hours it got posted. And if you see the next post of last night or whatever, you can check back. Posted 2 hours back, 3 hours back, 4 hours back. Right? You can check back. And if you check back, in the last 4 months, you will see most of the content are coming every day. Every single day. A blog is coming, quotes are coming, exclusive content for WhatsApp are coming. So WhatsApp is people, what people use. Since it's Indian, people love free things. Anything which is free is wow. Let not spend money, it's free. Let not buy image. Let's choreify some image from Google. Let not write content. Let's do some cut paste from other people's content. Google don't like it. So Google will never allow you that you grow. So most of the content have to be done on a regular basis. Otherwise, you're going to die. In fact, I wrote a blog, How to Die Digitally. Suicide, 20 things to do to suicide so that you die fast. So these are the rules. If you do it, you will definitely go to die. This is the biggest problem I see. Most people feel, don't know. How many people know here, content writer and copywriter? There are two different people. Raise hand, don't worry. Do you know this difference? If you know, then raise hand. I know most of you will not raise hand because I've been asking this question for the last 4 years. Not much corporate people, twice qualification you have raised hand. Because none of the people I see here understand what is the difference between content writer and a copywriter. Someone asked me, for an easy example, is poet who writes what? Episodes, like. So to a different form, poet is what you write in a small thing. And when you make an episode, when you make a huge author, a book, which is like 500 pages, it's not the same thing. It is something to do with writing, but not the same thing, right? So these are problems. A copywriter, do you know? The copy guy, he will think throughout the day, and he will write one or two copy, and he paid 50 to 60,000 rupees if he's senior. And if he's not senior, he gets 25,000 rupees. Writing one or two line only. One or two line is not even a para or a page. On the reverse, this guy who writes pages after pages after pages, get 25,000 rupees if he's junior, get 50,000 rupees if he got 6 or 7 experience. To a different type of people. Most people don't understand. So what happened? The copy you are blindly choosing someone who can write. It's like, I must tell you a quote. It's like, you have a DSLR, you become a photographer. I have a pen, so I'm an author. A writer, right? So you catch the wrong people. So you are actually catching the compounder thinking that he's a surgeon. Imagine what is happening to your heart surgeon who's operating it. Same thing happens. These I already spoke. Most people I see here. Everybody is an enthusiast. Okay? I'm a fashion enthusiast. I'm a Bitcoin enthusiast. I'm a digital anything which comes new, you need to go out with the trend and look little hip and fantastic. I said, wow. In your LinkedIn profile, they said, I'm a content enthusiast. So most people say, most of the time you will meet people or you will select people. If you're not very sure whom you are selecting, you'll end up picking a wrong guy. So enthusiasts and marketeers are two different things. Marketeers are like a doctor. They're very deep rooted. They're very deep, very deeper. And enthusiasts, you just like it. Let's give you an example. You love watching movies, right, everybody? So do you call yourself a filmmaker? No, right? Why? You should say film enthusiast. You like food. You can test the food. You like different palettes of it. So do you call yourself a chef? You like nice dresses. Can you call yourself a fashion police? No. Similarly, content, if you digital marketing, it's very, 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 it's called T-marketing. T-marketing. You have to go very deep down. Either social media, content, and design media, lyrics, UI, website, app, marketing of app, marketing of website, so many parameters. You need to have a deeper knowledge, otherwise, jack of all trades, master of none. You're not able to do it. You're not able to solve your own problem. This is most important. Everybody want a viral content. It's like asking, let's make a hit movie. There's no formula of hit movie. A good content, trend to get liked by customers or people or users and they become it, right? So there's nothing called viral. The moment your content value, you start giving value your content, you'll start getting traction from the people, user, customers. So don't look at content as a fast moving, money churning machine. Content takes a lot of time. But once you're done, you get sorted. I don't think so, but I must tell you this. There are process of making, now I'm going little deeper so that you get to understand. There's something called a pillar content. And there's something called a micro content. Right now, for an example, make it very easy for all of you. Here you can see, she's shooting the entire, my 2 hours talk or 1 hour talk on this topic. This goes little edited for a 7 minutes or 8 minutes or a 10 minutes goes to YouTube. That's the pillar content. Then she is going to cut and chop important part of content, so social, managing into smaller pieces and put it on Insta stories, Facebook stories, LinkedIn clips. Those are called micro content, which are micro, smaller. So first making pillar and then cropping and then putting. This is how you do this orchestra of making a pillar content and a micro content. Not much people do that. They will take one photo, one selfie, post everywhere. One video, post everywhere. It is not going cut somehow and somehow post. Doesn't work like that. Absolutely. This is quite complicated. I'll not go deeper. We'll have a real solutions for this next. While coming, I was thinking, how do I make all of you understand what is a content and how algorithm works? So all of you must have seen when you, in any movie, when you put a hose pipe on the planting your garden, there's one pipe and the flow comes, right? It goes straight and drop. And there's a tap. Most of the time we must have seen if the tap is closed, the water flow goes down. It falls its speed. And there's also something called a sprinkler. And they put it, you know, the mali puts like this. There are a lot of holes and the water gets sprinkled all over. That is how our algorithm works. Algorithm works like that. So there are channels. By the way, I must tell you, don't treat Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, TikTok, anything as a social platform. They are just pipe. Social pipe. Facebook has a pipe. Twitter is a pipe. LinkedIn is a pipe. TikTok is a pipe. What you put inside is the heart. That's the content. So each pipe, have you ever seen a hospital? There are two type of pipe, blue and red. So you can identify this is for oxygen, this is for something else, or maybe some other gas. Similarly, each pipe is different. So what I said in the morning, you can't have chicken thing at 4 o'clock in the morning. So that pipe is for food, light food. So each content is different. If you try to mix it up, nothing will work.